when fashion is become a passion, then the duration of the produced garment and wear in a shorter form. Change taste depends upon the taste the garments wearer, consumers, they are changing. The consumption is increasing day by day because of the passion, because of the fashion. Hi friends, how are you? In this video clip, I am going to talk on chemical testing. Chemical testing of textiles. Chemical testing of fabrics, garments. You know, what is chemical testing? We are not a textile industry. Testing is tested nowadays since few years for chemicals also. Pharmaceuticals, biocides, okay, pesticides and other areas also tested chemicals, because and food also tested for chemicals. Now, since few years, textiles, fabrics, garments also tested for chemicals. Chemicals means not sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid, carbon monoxide, oxygen present in the garments. We are talking about the breathability of the fabrics. Whether the garment is breathe oxygen, inhale oxygen or exhale carbon dioxide. No. We are testing. It is an essential need of the present day, 21st century, for chemical testing also. Friends, garments or fabrics produced by using some processes, that is wet processes, that involves chemicals, that requires chemicals. To dye a yarn, to dye a fabric, to dye a garment, or to wash a garment with enzymes or silicones, whatever finish is going to be given to the fabrics or garments, that may be water repellent finish, fire retardant finish, antimicrobial finish, anti-wrinkle finish, number of finishes are there. Okay, so and also dyeing of the fabrics. In dyeing, to dye a fabric, there is a preparatory process is there. Singeing, sizing, desizing, scouring, bleaching, mercerization, then dyeing, then finishing, number of finishes. These are all wet processes. The fabrics or garments immersed in the solutions, that solution containing chemicals. Scouring chemicals, mercerization chemicals, sizing chemicals, bleaching chemicals, dyeing chemicals. Dyeing powder is made of some chemicals, some reagents and also reagents, activators. Okay, many chemistry is there. Textile chemistry is there. Weaving, spinning, other things. Spinning, weaving, knitting, with that, textile chemistry. Textile chemistry is a part. Textile chemistry involved use of chemicals. Once upon a time, caustic soda is added. Some chemicals they have used with or without knowledge, some without knowledge. When invention taken place, when research taken place once upon a time in the globe, the essential to use those chemicals in the product, to in the finish, in the process, and supplied, finished and supplied. But later, nowadays, not nowadays means I'm already late. What I'm talking is already late, is there? About the chemicals. Some chemicals found abnormal to the human health, abnormal to the environment, greenery of the environment. the fabrics processed with the some chemicals that is owned by the consumer wearer affected without his knowledge in a long-term process with the cancer, with the skin cancer, irritations, and so many other things are there. Okay, that we cannot expect. Invisible, like virus, invisible virus, how they attack the human health, like that invisible chemicals present in the goods that will attack. What are those chemicals which are necessary to use, whether they are necessary, whether they are essentially a must and should be used? Yes, some chemicals to finish textiles, to make a garment, to make a fabric, to give a particular specific colors, shades, required. Some chemicals are required. But they are harmful. They are harmful. They make adverse effect on human health or environment. Okay, no? And some chemicals are there. We can use instead of, or substitute, or alternative chemicals can be used. That research is going on.